How can I combine surface and intracellular targets in my flow cytometry experiment, and how do I design my multiplex protocol? I'm Rob, Senior Research Associate in the Flow Cytometry Group at Cell Signaling Technology, and this is CST Tech Tips. Combining intracellular readouts with surface phenotyping enables you to carry out more powerful experiments. You can ask not only who the cells are, but what they are doing, saving time and precious samples in the process. If you are considering adding intracellular readouts to the surface markers in your antibody panel, finding a compatible protocol presents considerations which I'll go over in this video. There's no single combination of reagents that works with every antibody panel, but in general, with thoughtful planning, you can find a protocol that works with your antibody panel. The flow cytometry team at CST has a lot of experience developing protocols as part of our antibody validation efforts, so I can share what we've learned. So what's different about intracellular flow cytometry? To detect intracellular proteins with an antibody, the cell membranes need to be permeabilized. Intracellular proteins must also be locked in place using a fixative before permeabilization, so they don't diffuse away. Meanwhile, the antibodies directed against surface epitopes, such as CD markers, often have been developed for use on live cells. Many, but not all, of these antibodies also have the flexibility to specifically detect their target after fixation and permeabilization. We've put together a reference table for many of our CD marker antibodies with their protocol compatibility. We'll include a link in the description box below the video if you want to check that out. If all of your surface markers are known to be compatible with a fixation and permeabilization protocol, this means you can simply incubate all your antibodies together in one step. On the other hand, if you don't have information on protocol compatibility for one of your surface marker antibodies, you can set up a simple experiment. Take two aliquots of live cells and fix and permeabilize one of the aliquots following the protocol you are using for your intracellular antibodies. Then, label both your live and fixed aliquots with your surface marker antibodies, wash, and compare cytometry results. Make sure you can still clearly distinguish your positive and negative populations in the fixed and permeabilized cells. If your surface marker antibody doesn't work, here are two things to try. First, you can consider alternative reagents for permeabilization. For example, if methanol isn't compatible with your surface markers, try switching to a detergent. Check with the manufacturer or test for compatibility with both your intracellular and extracellular targets. Second, if the surface marker antibodies are not compatible with fixed cells, split up your antibody incubation into two discrete parts. You can incubate your surface marker antibodies with live cells first, then fix and permeabilize the cells, and finally incubate with intracellular antibodies. This approach often results in the best staining, but it can be tricky to manage the timing if your experiment also includes a stimulus or perturbation. You'll also need to confirm the fluorophores for your antibody conjugates are compatible with the permeabilization reagent. Methanol denatures protein-based fluorophores like PE and APC, reducing or destroying their fluorescence. Consider using small molecule fluorophores, as these are generally not impacted by solvents. Thanks for watching! If you found this video helpful, give it a like and share it with your colleagues. And for more tech tips, hit that subscribe button. Anytime you have a question about an antibody or a protocol, get in touch with a CST scientist at cellsignal.com/support. Good luck with your experiments, and we'll see you next time.